Mummy, I know what to say to people. Frog. Frog. Call them. Hi guys, it's Tilly here. My mum's a little wants me to sit on her lap. She still thinks that I'm a baby, but I'm not. And if you can see, we got the incubator here. And there's eggs behind you, and there's eggs at that side of you.
There's eggs everywhere.
Yeah, there's eggs.
So we've just been through the difficult decision of what eggs to put in the incubator, as all you crazy chicken people will probably understand.
Yeah.
All of the eggs, not enough space in the incubator. So we've whittled it down and we've chosen the breeds that we want to put in and we'd like
I got bantams.
Tilly's got little bantams, sable poot, booted bantams. So she wants to put some of those in.
Yeah, so we can have much more and we hope that we don't have any more cockerels, only two hens, or maybe a couple of hens.
We'd like all hens ideally, but you know, the odds are 50-50, so we just have to take what we get. So the other breeds that we've chosen to incubate are our Bress, because they make good dual purpose breeds, and the Light Sussex as well.
Should I take off the lid of the incubator?
Yeah, and the Light Sussex, and also some olive eggers crossed with Welsomers. So the hens that result from that cross will either give us nice brown eggs or olive. Shall we get on and have a little look at the incubator?
Yeah!
So the incubator that we use is a Brinsea Octagon 40. We get on with filling this up and I'll show you how to operate
it. It's not a chatting video, guys. It's not a chatting video. It's an egg video.
So the only control on it, it's got a twisty knob control for the temperature and it's got an LCD display for the temperature as well. I also back that up with a regular glass bulb thermometer. Just in case anything goes wrong there. And I add a little hydrometer in as well so we can keep an eye on the humidity. But generally our house requires a small amount of water adding during the first 18 days to keep it to that 45% mark, and then we do need to add water then for the last 3 days of the lockdown to bring it up to 65%. Now don't just rely on the numbers. I'll pop a diagram here where it will show you the ideal air sac loss over the period of the incubation so that you can tell whether you need to add water or not. It's much better than just going by the whole, it's 45% for the first 18 days and 65 for the last 3 days.
Okay.
This is the Brinsea Octagon 40, and you can see the LCD screen just there, and the adjustment knob is on the side. And there's a space for the glass bulb thermometer on the inside, just there, and those are the fans that just keep the air circulating. So what we tend to do is leave it running for about 24 hours to make sure that we can get up to temperature, and then we start thinking about loading the eggs up. So it's nice and full up now. So we need to put the top on. And this has got its own cradle, so it'll automatically turn.
Rock my baby on the treetop.
Yeah, just like that for these little eggies. And we will candle them in 10 days' time. 10 days with candling and see what we got.
10 days!
Okay, so we will get back to you and let you know what the candling looks like,
yeah.
And hopefully we'll be on to a winner.
Yeah, hooray!
Okay, bye everybody.